Good morning and welcome to Advent Episcopal Church on this brisk, sunny second Sunday of Advent. We're delighted to have you here. I advise you to keep your jackets on today. The heat doesn't appear to be working. We'll get that fixed tomorrow, but we're glad that you're here anyway, and we can all comfort one another in our, it's going to be fine. You know, the sun is out. We're going to warm up just fine. We're delighted that you're watching on Facebook and on YouTube Live. Thank you for being with us. We hope that you'll check in on both of those medium and be sure to tell us, give us a comment or something, let us know where you're watching from, particularly if you're watching from out of state. We like to know who's following us from across the country. So in a moment, we'll begin the prelude and we'll sit in silence for that as we prepare our hearts and minds for worship of Almighty God. Again, welcome to Advent.
Be seated.
As the prophet Isaiah urges the people of Israel, may we too prepare the way of the Lord, throwing out those things that weigh us down, distract us, and make us sleepy. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades. When the breath of the Lord blows upon it, surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up on a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear, say the cities of Judah. Here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join me in unison reciting Psalm 85. You have been gracious in your land, O Lord. You have restored the good fortune of Jacob. You have forgotten the iniquity of your people and blotted out all their sins. I will listen to what the Lord God is saying, for he is speaking peace to his faithful people and to those who turn their hearts to him. Truly, his salvation is very near to those who fear him, that his glory may dwell in all our land. Mercy and truth have met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other. Truth shall bring from the earth, and righteousness shall look down from heaven. The Lord will indeed grant prosperity, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness shall go before him, and peace shall be the pathway for his feet. The coming of the Lord is not a predictable moment allowing us to procrastinate. It is the culmination of living each day and each moment with faithfulness. A reading from the second letter of Peter. Do not ignore this one fact, beloved, that with the Lord one day is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years are like one day. The Lord is not slow about his promise, as some think of slowness, but is patient with you, not wanting any to perish, but all to come to repentance. But the day of the Lord will come like a thief, and then the heavens will pass away with a loud noise, and the elements will be dissolved with fire, and the earth and everything that is done on it will be disclosed. Since all these things are to be dissolved in this way, what sort of persons ought you be in leading lives of holiness and godliness, waiting for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heavens will be set ablaze and dissolved, and the elements will melt with fire? But in accordance with his promise, we wait for new heavens and a new earth, where righteousness is at home. Therefore, beloved, while you are waiting for these things, strive to be found by him at peace, without spot or blemish, and regard the patience of our Lord as salvation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
The beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, the Son of God. As it is written in the prophet Isaiah, "See, I am sending you my messenger ahead of you, who will prepare your way. the voice of one crying out in the darkness. Prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. John the Baptizer appeared in the wilderness, proclaiming a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. And people from the whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem were going out to him and were baptized by him in the River Jordan, confessing their sins. Now John was clothed with camel's hair, with a leather belt around his waist, and he ate locust and wild honey. He proclaimed, "The one who is more powerful than I is coming after me. I am not worthy to stoop down and untie the thong of his sandals. I have baptized you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord.
Let us pray. God, without whom nothing is strong, nothing is holy, grant us a glimpse of your glory, that our eyes may be opened and the world transfigured for us, that we may see your glory in all things, in the entire earth full of your glory. In your name, so be it. Amen. Always we begin again, goes the Benedictine saying. We experience a lifetime as a series of repetitions, each one a little further along the way. Every year, we celebrate a birthday, yet tell it to our ego or psyche, and each will deny it. In our minds, we're all stuck in our prime, whatever age we determine that to be. It is only our body that appears to grow in each age, each year, and quite convincingly, too. Though I've only seen it in a documentary hosted by Bill Moyers about Judaism, when the reader at the Bema in a synagogue comes to the end of the Torah, I'm told that the lector holds their breath until the Torah is turned back to the beginning, the book of Genesis, and starts reading again at the beginning from the breath it was held. What makes this challenging is that the Torah is usually a long scroll and must be rolled all the way back in order to say, "In the beginning, God." And of course, "in the beginning" is the literal translation of the word Genesis. Every day, we begin again. As the earth turns the sun into view over the eastern horizon and out of view over the western horizon every 24 hours, we call it a day. And we see the earth itself turning through the years, hurtling at 64,000 miles per hour on a journey of 548 million miles around the star we call our sun, over the space of 365.25 days that we call a year. And lest I forget, you have 19 shopping days until Christmas, because the consumer culture has decreed that Christmas time is here, the most wonderful time of the year. Always, always, we begin again. Advent heralds the beginning of the new year for the church again. We begin every year in waiting, in preparation for the birth of Jesus, the first coming of Christ, the anointed one, into the world. It seems appropriate to tell a story with the beginning and let it unfold to its climax and dramatic finish. And all good stories have a structure that not only offers a beginning, a middle, an end, but usually a good story has a conflict that must be overcome, often to a stunning reveal and a satisfying, if not happy, ending. These are the basic rules of quality storytelling. And the Gospel according to Mark breaks all the rules. Mark breaks all the rules because it gives you the reveal in the beginning. Without so much as a spoiler alert, Mark tells you that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, in the opening line. I mean, you just heard her read it. Who does that? Why bother to tell the story at all now? We all know how it ends. And I say tell the story very deliberately, because it is most likely that the Gospel of Mark was conveyed as a storytelling event before it was ever written down. And the Gospel of Mark works beautifully as a storytelling event. Now, you can find a very fine quality version of the Gospel of Mark told as a story by a man called Max McLean, M-C-L-E-A-N, or capital L, Max M-C, capital L-E-A-N, Max McLean. It's on YouTube. Just search on Gospel of Mark, Max McLean. And my, is it powerful when presented that way. And you know, it'll take you less than 2 hours to watch it. And you would be mesmerized. Advent begins with the story of the beginning of Jesus' ministry, introduced by John the Baptizer at the River Jordan. Mark's story, told in haste here at the beginning, draws us right in because it says all the people of Jerusalem were going out to see and hear John in the desert and being mesmerized and baptized by him. Quite a picture to imagine, don't you think? Here at the beginning of the good news of Jesus Christ, Advent invites us to step into the story once again and become part of the coming incarnation event as sons and daughters of God. The Gospel of Mark, when effectively told by the church, is not just a listening event, but a participatory event. We step into the story with our lives because it is through our lives that we share the story by our response to the story, our engaging the story at the gut level, by our living like Jesus to embody the story, which conveys the good news. God is very near to us, loves us incessantly, and that all we need do is to trust that love and let it change our way of thinking and acting and living in this life, in this world. People need good news these days, don't you think? So many of us are so tired of this year, the length of its days, the seemingly endless cases of new COVID-19 infections, new hospitalizations, and the ever-increasing death toll now surpassing 280,000 souls in the U.S. alone. People need the good news of God's love, but in a specific way. People need the good news of God's love for the world expressed through our love of neighbor, of community member, of fellow citizen, fellow human being. Do you realize that when you express your care and compassion for another, you express God's care and compassion for that someone? You see, God loves others through you. God loves the world through you. At the same time, God loves you and enables you to love. And if each one of us could be quicker to recognize this in ourselves and less quick to judge ourselves or others for any reason, we could weather any storm that life throws at us, combat any virus that dares to affect us, because we would know God's love for each of us, having experienced God's love within our own heart and mind and innermost being. When you think about it, these days, wouldn't be hard for each one of you to think of someone who could use an expression of God's love from you. Now, the most important thing here is to stop disqualifying ourselves before we even get started at this. When my friend Dave began his feeding ministry among the hungry and homeless of North Central Phoenix. He tried as hard as he could to disqualify himself while making sandwiches. Who am I to think I can do this? What if they don't want my sandwiches? What would they think of me for attempting to do this? And on this last one, Dave recalls God saying to him, "Hey, I don't care what they think about you, Dave. I care what they think about me. And when you bring the hungry food, they're going to see that I care for them, that they matter to me. After all, they've prayed for something to eat, and you're giving it to them for me. It's not about what they think of you, Dave. It's about what they think of me and that they can trust me." So here we are once again. Always, we begin again. The beginning of a new year, a new opportunity to follow Jesus in a new way, an unexpected way for yourself. Don't be afraid. Step out in faith. Be God's good news for someone who needs good news. And try not to worry what people think about you. After all, it isn't about what people think about you that matters. All that matters is that by what you do, people see that God loves them and cares for them and that they can trust God. And when we can do that for others, then we see and experience once again for ourselves that God loves us and cares for us and that we can trust God as well. And that, sisters and brothers in Christ, is good news. Amen.
Sisters and brothers, it is only when we love one another that we can truly say, we believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshiped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The prayers of the people this morning are taken from the Book of Common Prayer and enriching our worship. You'll find their response to each petition in the bulletin or on the screen of the live stream. For the Church of God in every place, that it may persevere in faith and hope, we pray to you, O God. We pray for Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, for Michael, our presiding bishop, for Jennifer, our bishop, for Brian, Debbie, Gary, Janet, Janice, Meg, and Timothy, our clergy, for Sharon, our licensed lay pastoral care minister, and for all bishops, priests, and deacons, and all other ministers, that they may have the grace to build up your people in love. We pray to you, O God. For all who fear God and believe in you, Lord Jesus, that our divisions may cease and that all may be one as you and the Father are one. We pray to you, O God. For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness it may preach the gospel to the ends of the earth. We pray to you, O God. For those who do not yet believe, and for those who have lost their faith, that they may receive the light of the gospel, we pray to you, O God. For the peace of the world, that a spirit of respect and forbearance may grow among nations and peoples, we pray to you, O God. For a spirit of reconciliation and right relationship with our Native American relatives, that we may be a healing presence in this place, we pray to you, O God. For those in positions of public trust, that they may serve justice and promote the dignity and freedom of every person, we pray to you, O God. For the men and women of our armed forces or other national service, for all troops and civilians in harm's way in regions of conflict around the world, for doctors, nurses, all hospital personnel, and all first responders and their families, and for those affected nationwide and around the world by the coronavirus, we pray to you, O God. For those affected by natural disasters, especially those states ravaged by hurricanes and wildflowers, and those cities affected by civil unrest, we pray to you, O God. For all who live and work in the several communities surrounding us, we pray to you, O God. For a blessing upon all human labor and for the right use of the riches of creation, that the world may be freed from poverty, famine, and disaster, we pray to you, O God. For the poor, the persecuted, the sick, and all who suffer, for refugees, prisoners, and all who are in danger, that they may be relieved and protected, we pray to you, O God. For this congregation, for those who are present, and for those who are absent, that we may be delivered from hardness of heart and show forth your glory in all that we do, we pray to you, O God. For our enemies and those who wish us harm, and for all whom we have injured or offended, we pray to you, O God. For all who have commended themselves to our prayers, for our families, friends, and neighbors, that being freed from anxiety, they may live in joy, peace, and health, we pray to you, O God. For Joanne Lawrence, Elizabeth Martinez, Richard Sully, Jack Prydell, Ronald Bache, Donna Raskovitz, Timothy Dombeck, Maureen Haskell, Diane Diaz, and Richard Raskovitz celebrating birthdays this week. And for Ray and Judy Laffin, Michael and Jerrica Diaz, and William and Jean Hacker celebrating their anniversary, we pray to you, O God. For our mission companion diocese, the Diocese of Western New Mexico, Bishop Ricardo Onaya, for the Episcopal Church in Navajo Land, Bishop David Bailey, for St. Michael's Episcopal Church Upper Fruitland, New Mexico, and for the life, work, and ministry of St. Paul's Episcopal Church, Payson, we pray to you, O God. For all who have died in the communion of your church and those whose faith is known to you alone, that with all the saints, they may have rest in that place where there is no pain or grief, but life eternal. We pray to you, O God.
O God, you made us in your own image and redeemed us through your Son. Look with compassion on the whole human family. Take away the arrogance and hatred which infect our hearts. Break down the walls that separate us. Unite us in bonds of love. And work through our struggle and confusion to accomplish your purposes on earth, that in your good time, all nations and races may serve you in harmony around your heavenly throne. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life.
Amen.
Please be seated. Well, this is one of those fun things we get to do from time to time. Today is Debbie's fifth anniversary of ordination. You can pull your mask down. Tell us, this was it Boise? Where were you ordained to the diaconate? And what church was that?
St. Stephen's Episcopal Church.
Yeah, and then you promptly moved here, right? Basically, or something like that?
Yeah, we moved here.
Oh, you don't have a microphone, do you? That's okay. Keep speaking. All right. Go ahead. You can borrow mine. You moved here when then?
In March of 2017.
Great. And then she worshipped here in hiding for several months before she finally outed herself to me that she was a deacon. And we are so delighted to have you here. And you've added so much to our life here at Advent. And we want to... So I want to say a prayer for you. Debbie, may the Lord God always be with you in your going out and your coming in. May the Lord fill your heart and your mind with his love in Jesus Christ. And on this day, the anniversary of your ordination, may the Lord always inspire you to share that love with all those whose lives you touch. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Now, would you go to the lectern, please, and offer Christ's peace to God's people?
Thank you.
Please stand.
Yes. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you. Peace be with you. Peace, everybody. And please be seated. Once again, welcome to Advent. We're delighted to have you here. We'll have communion today. Again, I remind you to wait for your usher to come at the side aisle of your pew and to dismiss you, to come forward one person at a time and receive communion. Debbie will be right over here at the black X, I guess. I will stand over here at this black X. And same thing for you all. You'll come down the side aisle. If you're a household, you can come up together, obviously. Watch yourselves if you're trying to maintain 6 feet or more as you go back the center aisle to circle back to your pew. In Advent, and I think in Epiphany, we have been using Eucharistic Prayer C. If you're watching at home, that starts on page 369 and 70 and following in your prayer book. For us, it's page 3 of our service bulletin. The thing about Prayer C is that you have a lot more lines than usual. So I just like to say, stay on your toes, okay? You know, the black italicized things are for you to say all together. But it's great prayer. It was the first prayer I ever celebrated with as a priest on my ordination, the day after my ordination. So it means a lot to me. Plus, it's just a beautiful prayer for this time of year. And it's drawing the imagery on the celestial heavens because we're looking to those heavens for the coming of Christ. So just a FYI, be prepared for quicker responses than you normally. You can't cruise through on this one on memory, okay? You got to stand there with the bulletin. You got to be ready to respond. I think that's everything I need to know. Oh, and also at the end, please remember to be seated. The postlude will play, and the ushers again will dismiss you from the back, and we ask you to go to the door nearest to whatever side you're on, to go out that door as you exit. And again, thank you for being here. Thank you for joining us online. We're delighted to be worshiping with you all today. The offertory sentence. Gary, would you offer one, please?
Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and a sacrifice to God. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise.
Glory to you forever and ever.
At your command, all things came to be. The vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets and their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home.
By your will, they were created and have their being.
From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another.
Have mercy, Lord, and listen to your sighs.
Again and again, you called us to return. Through the prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law, and in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace. And therefore we praise you, joining with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, and martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. And so, Father, we who have been redeemed by him and made a new people by water and the Spirit, now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of Jesus Christ our Lord. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, he took the bread, said the blessing, broke it, and gave it to his friends and said, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, gave thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering now his work of redemption and offering to you this sacrifice of thanksgiving,
we celebrate his death and resurrection as we await the day of his coming.
Lord God of our fathers, God of Abraham, Isaac and Sarah, God of Abraham and Sarah, Isaac and Rebekah, Jacob, Rachel and Leah, and all the rest of them. God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Let the grace of this Holy Communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in his name.
Risen Lord, be known to us in the break and the bread.
Accept these prayers and praises, Father, through Jesus Christ, our great High Priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia. Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. For those who cannot join us for Holy Communion, you may receive spiritually in your heart by faith. Now, this is the teaching of the church. You receive Christ spiritually, a real presence, but without the elements of bread and wine. There is a prayer that we're going to say now for those who would like to receive Christ personally. My Jesus, I believe that you are truly present in the blessed sacrament of the altar. I love you above all things and long for you in my soul. Since I cannot receive you in the sacrament of your body and blood, virtually into my heart, cleanse and strengthen me with your grace, and let me be never separated from you. May I live in you and you in me in this life and a life to come. Amen. Please be seated.
body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven.
Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with your spiritual food, the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you and scatter the darkness from before your path. And the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always.
Amen. Until the ushers come to dismiss you. And we thank you for tuning in on the live stream. And again, I hope you've left some comments and let us know where you're listening from or watching from. Glad to have you with us. We'll be here Wednesday night at 5 o'clock. I'm actually going to have a Eucharist Wednesday night. It's the 28th anniversary of my ordination to priesthood. So if you want to come and party, you know, I don't know what that means. But if you'd like to come and join us, you're welcome to. But at any rate, and then next Sunday, of course, 9 a.m., here again at Advent Episcopal Church. So blessings on your week. Have a great day and be careful and be safe out there.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Well, you enjoy. That's a great honor. 28